What's up, y'all? Gerald here, creator of Gospel Chops and your host for this YouTube channel, back with another video. Now, if you followed this channel for some time, you've seen me talk about the industry ad nauseum. Y'all might be tired of it, but I'm telling you, if you stick around here, you're gonna hear me beat this like a drum in a drum shed until we get it as a community, as a culture. And you've seen me over time. I've gone from dealing with 20-somethings to dealing with teenagers to dealing with 10-year-olds, adolescents. Why? Because I'm trying to reach the youth at a point before they get corrupted by this industry. And it seems like an insurmountable task because the younger you go, you find the same results. How can it be that an 8-year-old has the same mental deficiencies as a 15-year-old? How can it be that a 5-year-old is asking to listen to Pound Town and Cardi B and all manner of foolishness? Look, y'all, I can only go so low. I can't try to reach the children in the womb. But what they're getting at home is so damaging. It's so detrimental to their mental health, to their social growth. It's sad. And this woman here in this viral video is telling her story. Someone else who's doing the work in the community. Y'all, we out here. This woman is trying to teach ballet to young girls in the hood, I assume. She's trying to put a positive mentality, trying to plant some seeds in their mind that will grow as they become older. But she's frustrated with the situation because she's seeing the damage that these parents are doing to these kids at such a young age. It's frustrating. It's heartbreaking. It's depressing. Sometimes it makes you want to give up. As she expresses here, let's get into this video and I'll give you my analysis on the backside. Check it out, y'all.
Pre-K to elementary school to high school, I'm calling you out. The children today, I have never experienced, and I'm 22. Having to teach and work with you guys as children has been the most traumatic experience of my life. I teach 5-year-olds ballet, 5-year-old girls ballet. I have a class of 10 students. They don't respect any authority. You ask them, can you stand in your designated spot? They're telling you no and shut up. They're throwing things at each other. They're throwing things at other people, other classmates. You say, can everybody sit in their spot? I don't want to. I'm not doing that. You don't get to tell me what to do. You're not my mom. You confront the parent. The parent tries to argue with you and fuss at you because you tried to reprimand and redirect their kid. I told a young little girl, please sit in your spot. You're not my mom. You don't tell me what to do. Okay. When her mom came to pick her up, I said, hey, your daughter's having a hard time following instructions. And 7 times today, I've had to redirect her to just sit in her spot. Well, clearly she didn't want to sit. And mind you, this is a mom. Clearly she didn't want to fucking sit right there. So, I mean, if she's telling you she don't want to do something, why keep asking her to do it? You know she's not going to do it. What world do we live in? Like, what in you guys' brain as a parent says, my kid not following any directions is a great thing. It's not that serious. And y'all don't have a right to tell her what to do. It's sad. It's sad. It's really, really sad. And another thing that's heart-wrenching is horrifying. It is horrifying. Your 5-year-old daughters are asking to listen to Pound Town and Ski Yee. Your daughters, your 5-year-old daughters are asking, can we hear Pound Town? I'm playing them Princess Tiana ballet music. And they are asking me, can we hear Pound? because this is the most insane agenda push I have ever seen in my life. We do freeze dance. You guys' daughters are twerking at five. Where is the parenting? Where is the boundaries? Where is the help? Y'all are not helping your kids. You're hurting them. You guys are hurting them. I come every day dressed, ready to go, and I'm in school too. I'm in college. I mean, I put bows in my hair. I'm wearing leotards. I'm trying to get them interested in like proper things for their age, and you guys are exposing your kids to this raunchy secular music. Why is you guys' 5-year-old daughter singing Pound Town?
And there you have it, y'all. The story of a 22-year-old college student who's teaching ballet to young girls, trying to give them a positive image, something to look at other than these half-naked rappers that they see on TV all day, every day. And it's not working. It seems like the media onslaught is insurmountable. She's voicing her frustration. We all face it, sis. I'm just as frustrated as you. Because just like you face it in your arena, I face it in mine. And we're all trying to do a positive work out here and change the mentality of the culture. But man, when you got billion-dollar media conglomerates that are pushing this agenda, I'm glad she noted that it's an agenda push. That's what it is, sis. And we out here fighting against it, and we can only as individuals do so much. I hope that at some point we can find a mechanism to unite our strengths, our forces. We're all out here as individuals fighting the good fight. But at some point we're going to have to get our strength up, because it seems like this media onslaught is winning. Especially when you have 5-year-old girls talking about, can I hear Pound Town? What do you know about Pound Town? You 5 years old. You in kindergarten. That's the evidence that this starts at home. And if we're going to change the culture, y'all, we're going to have to change the home. It's not going to be easy. Hasn't been easy up to this point. But if we're going to make a difference, that difference starts with us. Let me know what you think about this video. I'm curious because we're out here fighting it. We're trying to do the right thing. And I thought that if I approach the youth at a younger age, I can reach them before they were corrupted by this culture. But the lower you get, you find the same mentality. And it's amazing that this mentality can be implanted in these children's minds at such a young age. The devil is in the midst, y'all. Let me know what you think about this sister's complaint, explanation, whatever you want to call it. She's expressing from her heart. She's telling you what she's dealing with. This is her personal experience, and she's mad at some of y'all single mothers for the damage that you're doing to these babies. Y'all like the video? Subscribe to the channel and share the video so we can get more people involved in the conversation, y'all. And like I always say, always remember and never forget. Without the gospel, it's just chops. Until next time, peace.